Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk. This is the Honor 20 and today is my accessibility video where we go through all the settings and the options and some of the features that you can change and adjust to make this device your own, no matter your ability. So let's delve right in. So first of all, there's a couple of options that you can choose to start off with. So when you go through the setup process, when you first get your phone, you can actually select the options you want to use then, which I think is a really good positive thing to see. Also, when it is set up, you can also turn on Talkback automatically by using a volume key shortcut. So what you want to do is make sure your volume is turned up first of all. So if I press and hold the volume keys together here,
Talkback on, draw home.
Okay, so it's told you it's on its home page. So we're on the home page currently. And then you can go through and select different applications.
Phone, messages, apps, Chrome, phone, double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it gives you options. And then if you need to manipulate between pages, left or right or up and down, use two fingers and then just simply swipe across.
Screen two of three.
And it will tell you which screen you're on of a certain number. So we're back home. And then if you want to open an application, so if we go to the app drawer.
Apps. App drawer opened.
A quick double tap again opens this up and you can see all of your applications. You can slide through here. Again, you get that ticking noise up and down depending where you are. So that is Talkback via the buttons. Also, there's Talkback in the accessibility option. But it doesn't just work on your main home screen. You can actually highlight different things up here in your taskbar as well.
Weather, 1851. Battery, 89%. Ringer vibrate, NFC enabled.
So you can go through there and work through everything that you need to find out. So it's a great option. And then to turn back off, if you need to turn it back off, press and hold the volume keys
vibration,
again.
Vibration, music volume, Talkback off.
Also, you notice you've got an accessibility limit there as well for your volume control. So you've got different options there that you can choose from and adjust depending on what you need it to do. So to actually find your accessibility settings, what we need to do is jump into settings here. Then in settings, scroll down until you see smart assistance. Click in this section. So a little bit buried in the menu options, but it's okay. We get to see all of our options here. So if I just zoom in a little bit, at the top here, you have accessibility. So if we click on accessibility here, it's split into different sections. So we're going to start with audio section. Your first option is actually Talkback. And Talkback, I've gone through and explained exactly what that does. But you can go in here, change and adjust everything you need to, toggle it on here if you need to use it. I think it's a great option, and I'm really pleased to see it on the device. So underneath that, you have select to speak. So go into select to speak here. It's toggled on. You'll see an accessibility man down here at the bottom. It'll give you a play and a stop button here. So if we play.
Navigate up. Select to speak. Select to speak. More settings. About. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
So it will go through and read everything that you've highlighted. So if I actually stop it here, press again and then actually press a text body, it will start from that section and not read from the top.
When select to speak is on.
So you actually choose which option you want it to be read to you. So say you was on a Facebook page and you wanted to read a post, or you was on, I don't know, you had a text message and you wanted to read that message to you. Tap, highlight that message, and then it will dictate it back to you. That is a great feature to have there, and I've used that quite a lot. Underneath that, you then have text to speech going inside here. This is where you can change your speech rate and your pitch. So you can actually hear a sample if you want to. You can reset. Set it back to normal. You can change and adjust it depending on the options that you need it to have. So I can reset here. And then obviously you're going to go through here, change and adjust which ones that you want best for you. Underneath that, you have mono audio. So if you need the ability to use mono audio, you can do. Then underneath that, you have captions. So this is a really important one. When toggled on, you can select your language here. You can then select your text size. Again, you can choose either very small, large, depending on your choice. Then you can actually choose your style and they give you six different ranges of styles there to choose from. So that's a really good option. And that's all the options you're going to find in the audio. Coming into visual, as you know, with my visual impairment, it's nice to see this section here. So color correction, you can go in and then you can select different options to change with color correction if you so want to. You then have magnification. So going inside magnification, toggle this on. One, two, three. Three quick taps will actually bring you into this large 6.26 inch display, the full view display from Honor. You can manipulate way around. One, two, three will bring you back. One, two, hold on the third will take you in. And then as soon as you release, we'll take you back out. So again, magnification option is good to have there, and I like to see that. Then you have a large mouse pointer. So if you're using a mouse pointer or an interaction device with your smartphone, you can use that here. Again, you can go in and you can turn this on and it'll give you further options. You then have color inversion. So if I toggle this on here, so it gives me a white text on a black background. If I go home, it actually inverts all of the colors here, as you'll see, and really completely changes it. Looks funky. Actually, I really like that. But I think for the process of the video, I'm going to carry on reading it like this so I can actually read it to you. Underneath that, you have high contrast text. So as you can see, it subtly changes the subtitles and the titles just by toggling that on and off there. You then have advanced visual effects. So again, you can turn these on or off depending if they're going to bother you. Then moving on to interaction control section, you then have switch access. So switch access gives you the ability to use switches in interaction devices with your smartphone depending on your need or your ability to use them. Like I said, you can have a large mouse pointer if you so wanted to actually use your phone and manipulate your way around your device. Really good option here. I do like to see this. Loads of different sub options to go through here. And if you do have any questions or queries about this, please do let me know. And I'm going to try and get some of these switches and some of these interaction devices to actually test with the phones. Instead of me just keep saying about it, I would like to actually show you as well and go into further detail about this section. So it's really important that they add this section, but you want to know if everything is going to work for you. So underneath that, you have accessibility shortcuts. So as you knew, I use the volume key shortcuts, and also you can change and adjust different other shortcuts on here. Again, a good option to have because you want to get into your accessibility settings as quick as possible. You then have touch and hold delay here, so you can click and change this depending on the option you need to change. After that, you've got click when cursor stops moving. Like I said, you use a cursor with your device. You can actually then automatically click or make a click come true when using this option here. Then you have your power button can end call. So your power button is built into the side mounted fingerprint sensor here, which is lightning fast and really good. And that's a good option to use. Then underneath that, you've got downloaded services. And this is where you're going to install other services that you might use, like third party options from Google and other third party applications that offer you accessibility help. You then have further options here in smart assistance. So high touch is a great option. This is where you can take a photograph of something or point it at something and it will actually let you know what it is, or you could use it to read text or read a sign. Again, a great feature, and I want to do a dedicated video on that, so please watch out for that. You then have one hand UI. So to activate one hand UI, if I swipe along the bottom here, it's letting me know what way I want it. So it's one hand UI down here at the corner. Tap the side and it becomes nice and big again and nice and easier for me to see. But again, I like to have that one hand UI, especially if I can reach nearly all the way over to that side, but it's good to have one hand UI. Underneath that, you have shortcut and gestures. So inside here, you have Google Assistant. You want to talk to your Google Assistant, and it's telling you you could power that on with the power button if you wanted to, or you could say, hey, G, or you could actually press and hold the home button and that'll bring up Google Assistant. So then you can take a screenshot as well by sort of knocking on the glass to take a screenshot. There we go, we've taken a screenshot down here. A great feature if you want to take a quick screenshot of something, send it off to someone. Then you move into record your screen. So it uses two knuckles to record, so just a double tap of your knuckles there, and that'll start to record your display for you. You then have a split screen. So a split screen is quite a cool option. So if I just swipe along here, so you saw it made that sharp line there. And then I can choose another application here to open. And you can have dual screen. So you can change and adjust the window depending on the size that you want. A really good feature to see here. Then you have wake screen. So that means when you raise it up, it's actually going to wake up and you can see your notifications. So you can mute ringtones and reduce volume. And that's by just simply sort of facing it down on the desk there. I like that feature, that helps. And there's another one here as well. When you pick it up, it's actually going to reduce the ringing volume anyway. And then finally at the bottom, you have answer calls. So bringing this up to your ear, it's going to detect that and it can answer the calls automatically for you. So loads of different gestures there and different options to choose from. Really like all of them. I think that's a really good thing to see. You then have voice control. So you can voice control different things here. So the voice control to wake up your Honor by saying, dear Honor. You can find your phone. Where are you? So I'll let you know where it is. If you've lost your phone, the lights are flashing on the back there.
I'm here.
So that's a really cool feature to actually use there. I've actually used it once already to find out where it is. So that's a really fun thing to actually use. And it's nice to see that voice control system on there. That's actually quite a lot compared to what we've seen previously. Underneath that, you have a digital headset. If you need to use a digital headset, that's where you're going to pair it up here. And you can change and adjust your settings when paired up. Underneath that is a smart cover. If you use a smart cover, you need to just toggle that on inside here. And that will help you use your smart cover with your device. Then you have Miss touch prevention at the bottom here, which is really cool. So if I touch here and touch here, it doesn't detect the actual mistouch prevention. So if you're trying to flick through something, but you still have a thumb resting up there, it's going to allow you to flick through. Now at the bottom, you've got scheduled power on and off. So you can actually power your device on and off at certain times. Really good with children. Then finally, looking for something else at the bottom here, you've got system navigation. So system navigation, you can actually go through and change. So you have the gesture control, you have the settings, or you actually have the navigation dock. To use all of the accessibility options, you do need the three key navigation option. Otherwise, you won't get the accessibility man appearing, and the settings seem to have a little bit of a wobble if you don't use this one and you use one of these two. So coming out of here, there are a couple of extras. So let's go back into our menu here. So what we're going to do is jump into display. So this is display. You can change your brightness depending on the level of brightness that you want. Then also, you've got color mode here. Color mode and temperature. This is where you can change and adjust your color mode and your temperature depending on what you need for your eyesight and your ability. I like this feature here that you can actually change, so you can go to natural, vivid. We've got the inverted colors on at the moment, just making it easier to read, but you can go through and change which ones that you want for you. So I do like to highlight this option is sleep. So if you take a long time to actually read something on your phone and you don't actually touch it, the screen will turn off. So on sleep here, I always set mine to never, but obviously this will impact battery life and it will impact your display as well because it's always on, and most of the time mine is on full brightness, but I just want to highlight where it is. Then you have eye comfort, and these devices are actually certified by Tuve Ryland, which means they're best for eye comfort control. And again, you can go through here, change and adjust which ones that you want for you. And I think that's really important that you can make it what you need it to be. I don't know why it's put in here. I can understand because it is about the display, but I think this needs to be shown in the accessibility as well. So you have text and display size. So you can go through and select which sort of text size you want. Also, you can make the display a bit bigger as well. And they have presets here at the top. Again, you can make it a bit smaller, up to you. It depends what choice you need it. And that's why I make this video. It's all showing you what you may need. You then also have screen resolution, as it is a very powerful screen. It will most probably come set as smart resolution, but I would recommend going to the FHD Plus, and it gives you the best resolution possible for your device when watching content and enjoying your photographs and enjoying your device. Then you have more display options down here, which has full screen display. Again, certain applications will allow you to change and adjust these. YouTube, I do. That means you can fully go out of the whole display and show everything on all of the display. You have your notch. So the notch at the top here, you can make disappear in a whole bar. So if I press this here, it's the whole bar. If not, the notch just stands out on the sort of side there, but it's barely noticeable. It really is barely noticeable. I think it's a really nice thing to see that they've put it so far in the corner. And also with the actual great options that they give, you can actually hide it with different wallpapers. Then finally at the bottom, they have simple mode. So you have simple mode here that strips everything away, just makes it very easy, very plain for you to use depending on your ability and your choice. So coming back home, and as I said there, the camera lens is actually hidden in the parrot's eye. So you don't need that massive black bar going across there. That would have been a distraction. This is less of a distraction. Even when you turn it around this way, you're not noticing the notch either. So it's really important. Just leave it the way it is for me. So let me know what you think. Really pleased with the amount of settings on here. Well, the power and performance inside this device as well will run as smooth as anything because it is using the latest Huawei Kirin 980 chipset inside here. Has 6 GB of RAM. It will fly through any accessibility needs that you have that you need to fire at it. If you do have any questions or queries, drop a comment down below and I'd be more than happy to do that. While you're there, please hit the like button, and if you haven't already, subscribe and ring the notification bell to Tech Talk, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye for now.